On Hatteberg's People, history is recorded sometimes by accident. Rosie Hughes and her husband Leon worked for decades taking pictures in the black community, and to them at the time, it wasn't anything special. But as time looks back, the pictures, Rosie's personal experiences, and the lives they chronicled become a window to history. Rosie Hughes is part of history. With her husband Leon teaching her, they were a photographic team who documented Wichita's African-American community from the 1940s through the 70s. Their pictures of everyday life are now a priceless part of the local African-American heritage.
I never thought that it would mount anything.
But it has. Now, Leon had always wanted to be a photographer.
His first little camera was out of Cracker Jack box.
That Cracker Jack camera was just the beginning. When they married, Leon taught Rosie the art of photography, and she loved it.
It was just a job, a hobby, you know, that we did. But now it's turning around, and people are getting concerned about what went on back in those years.
Those early years were ignored by white media. These pictures of everyday life wouldn't exist without the Hughes. Pictures of a generation past for generations future.
God knows what he's doing, and he made all of us. God wants us to love everybody.
Rosie and Leon both worked in the aircraft plants, but after hours, pictures were their passion.
Something he wanted to do all his life.
As the civil rights movement took hold in the 50s, Rosie was part of it. She and others participated in the sit-in at Wichita's Dockham drugstore downtown.
The manager never came out and said nothing to us. He never did. But he told his waitresses, don't serve them.
For Wichita, it was a turning point in desegregation, but all through her life, she says she'll never forget the moments of hate and prejudice she endured.
They would have us, his wife would have us come in, take care of their children, cook their meals, and I just couldn't, that was something I couldn't understand why all the hate was there.
On a full Wichita bus, Rosie was seated, a white woman also waiting to be seated. The woman looked at Rosie, called her a racial epithet, but the bus driver intervened.
Then she hollered out again, where I came from. Nigga sat in the back. So he says, lady, there's some seats back there in the back. If you want to sit down, you go back and sit down. If not, go back where you come from.
Her gentle laugh today masks the pain of segregation and inequality of years past.
I know a lot of things happen, but I'm a person that don't hold grudges.
Today, while the memory remains, so do the pictures. And it is these pictures from Rosie and Leon that become a priceless collection of Wichita memories. People gone, moments tendered, events lost to time, all in black and white.
I hope I've been a blessing to someone.